just one really nice piece of music that I so much like. And I want to welcome you all to this live stream from Reg's living room. Unfortunately, I haven't seen Reg and Andreas yet, but I'm sure they will come. So, but until then, I will entertain you a little bit because, you know, this is Valentine's weekend, and what better opportunity than to sing some love songs for you? And I have something exactly just for you, and I have my friend with me. So, Beast, can you please come with me? Hello. So nice to see you. Oh, hello. How are you doing? Yes, yeah, good, good, good. And, you know, I think we will sing one of my very favorite songs now, Beauty and the Beast. Yeah.
A little change, small to say the least, for the little scared, neither one prepared, Beauty and the Beast, ever just the same.
Andreas, see you.
Rich, come on. time. We know we're late. Sorry, guys. We know we're late.
It's going to be good.
Yes.
Welcome to live stream number 33.
We have been looking forward to this, but we just had some errands to do, so we
are. Yeah, and we've been just running. Lots going on, but hey, what a great day! See, yeah. it's beautiful
it's
weather.
So beautiful. And right. Welcome around the world from Canada, Denmark, Iceland, Faroe Islands, wherever you're watching from.
United States.
Happy to have you here.
Been Peru.
Okay, Reg, where do we open?
I just need to get a key. There we go. So, hey, nice plant. Are you ready? We are so ready. We're gonna have fun. Come on.
Be good. We really hope you didn't have to wait too long for us, but.
I know, sorry we're late. It's just how it goes sometimes, but it's all good.
And this is where you live,
yeah,
right?
We might as well
introduce where you live.
Yeah, this is
number
where
six.
Number
in
six
Humlevik.
In Humlevik. So this is my house. So,
well, why wait so long? We should hurry up, you know.
Yeah. Well, I mean, are we sure? Did you? Oh, you. I don't know if it's the right key. I gotta hit the key.
Don't be stupid, Reg.
Hello.
Are you ready?
Now we're coming.
Hey, Reg. Are you coming?
I'm coming.
So, okay, we're gonna get this close off.
Well, hello.
We're so sorry we were late. I was really not.
It's kind of just how it can go. You know, some days you think you got more time than you actually do, right?
That's right. And
so thanks for your patience. I'm glad you're here. Eva says there's people following. So I guess we're not in trouble.
No, good. And today is a very special weekend. In Denmark, it is fastelavn Sunday on tomorrow. That's like carnival where people dress up and beat the cat out of a barrel or something like that. And in where you're from,
yes, it's Valentine's
tradition.
Day. So it's like where all the hearts and there's balloons and they've made it really a big commercialized something. But it's all about giving people flowers and loving people and all that good stuff. So we'd like to sing a Valentine song for you.
Maybe a few.
Maybe one or two, yeah.
Take my hand.
gave my whole life to. For I can't help falling in love with you. For I can't help falling.
I think that's a really good time to, it's a good song, it's a good season to sing love songs to anybody and everybody out there, because, you know, we're all a little bit in lockdown in our different parts of the world, and it's kind of nice to know that love still exists.
So, exactly.
Yeah.
And it does.
Yes.
It does.
So, what do you think?
You even got some hugs today, didn't you? Not from me, from you tried your best. Reg is terrible because... You were not allowed to hug in this country, but Reg cannot live with that.
Well,
he wants to hug people.
The way I look at it, I've had COVID. You've had COVID. We're immune. So, you know, and anybody else who maybe has also had it.
So if you need a hug and you're near Humlebæk, just come over. I'm sure Reg would be open to give you one.
Yeah, because it's good.
We have another song that we wrote together. But before we sing Tell Me, I think we should have a little quiz.
Well, there's an idea. What's the question of the day, Andreas?
Well, the question of the day could be.
Because you see, Valentine's. So could it have anything to do with St. Valentine?
Yes. Let's have a quiz question about St. Valentine's. Or St. Valentine. In which year was St. Valentine martyred?
I see. I didn't know before this that St. Valentine was martyred.
I didn't either.
Apparently he was martyred. So, what year was he martyred? Was it in the year 269?
Or B, in the year of 496?
Or was it in the year of C, 226? 226?
Yeah. Or was it D, in year 462?
So, it was a couple of days ago, but we'd like you to answer the question. So, it's A, 269, B, 496, C, 226, D, 462. So in what year was he martyred? So you know what? We're going to sing another song and give you just enough time to be able to write your answers. All right?
Put it in the comments and get a chance of winning a prize.
Yeah, that's right.
Thank you.
and keep me from all harm. You say that you love me, and now I know it's true. You fill me completely. My heart belongs to you. You fill me completely. My heart belongs to you.
Oh, I'm so happy to be back. I'm so glad we get to connect with you again. I've missed you. It's been 3 weeks. Listen, we want to tell you, we're going to be coming back. We're planning now from now on.
Yep.
Every 2 weeks we'll be here. So that'll be the plan now that we got the recording pretty much out of the way. Things have settled down a little bit and how busy we've been. And so now we've decided that it'll be, we'll come back and do this every 2 weeks. So we'll be back, and what's the date? 2 weeks from now? I don't know.
We can check.
27th or something like that, I think.
I don't know.
But anyway, yeah, around the 27th. I think the 27th will be the next
27th.
Week. Yeah.
Next one.
So that's the next one. So just so you know, and then every 2 weeks after that, because I don't like going so long. It's too long. I missed you guys. But every week can be almost too much. So we got a lot going on. So.
Yeah.
Yes.
And
I guess we have to stop now. We have to stop the quiz. The quiz is done.
Good.
All right, good. So it's over. So now you...
Eva's wife is counting all the right answers.
That's
and
right.
We hope you, some of you guessed it.
So we need to sing another song.
Yeah.
And let's sing, we're going to sing something from The Lion King.
Also something to do with love.
Love, the theme of the day. Of day, when the heat of the rolling wind can be turned away, an enchanted moment, and it sees me through. It's enough for this restless warrior just to be with you. And can you feel the love? It is where we are. It's enough for this wide-eyed wanderer that we got this far. And can you feel the love tonight? How it's laid enough to make kings and vagabonds beneath the very best.
Wide-eyed wanderer that we
to make kings and vagabonds beneath the very best. It's enough to make kings and vagabonds beneath the very best.
Kings and vagabonds will just believe the very best. It's funny what love does to us.
Yeah.
Love just really can kind of set you free.
And that's what we need in this time, to believe the very best.
Oh, we sure do.
Yeah.
Because you know what? The sun still gets up whether the COVID does or not. So we're good.
And now we will believe that the best voter will win.
It sounds like a cowbell in the distance.
Yeah, it does.
From a Perry Boy's perspective, that sounds like a hell of a lot. So now, Andreas, are you going to draw? Now the answer was A, in the year 269.
Yeah.
So for those of you who cheated, shame on you. No.
But apparently there's a lot of people who already knew or cheated.
Yes. Or guessed right.
Let's see.
So let's see. And the winner is, ladies and gentlemen.
The winner is Lisa Maria Poulsen.
Well, Lisa Maria Poulsen,
We have so many names in that cup, but and Lisa Maria is one of those that have won quite a few times. But
we love her. She's a great
and
lady.
And we're so
good
happy
friend.
To give you her gift.
Yeah.
So Lisa Maria, something is on its way
on
to you.
On its way to you, all the way to Farm.
And I can tell you that I did not know anything about St. Valentine's maybe 1 hour ago. But then we decided we wanted to have a quiz, and what should the quiz be about? So I looked up in Wikipedia. Well, Stephen, our wretched son, thought it should be something with St. Valentine. So I looked up in Wikipedia, who was he? And from what I could read, he was born sometimes in the 3rd century. And he was persecuted because he was a Christian. So he was hiding, I think he was hiding in the catacombs, or his bones are in the catacombs. There's something to do with the catacombs in Rome. But at least he was imprisoned at some point. And in his, when he was in the prison, he had a talk with the daughter of the guy who kept him in the prison, his jailer.
Oh, the jailer, okay.
Yeah. So the jailer's daughter, he had a talk with her, and she was blind.
Oh.
So he laid his hands on her and healed her. And she was very thankful. And then maybe, and this is where we are not quite sure if this is true or not, but apparently they started writing some letters to each other.
Wow.
While he was in prison.
That's wild.
Yeah.
I never knew any of that stuff.
And he would sign his letters with my Valentine. No, that can't be true. I don't know, something. Your Valentine, something like that.
Oh.
Your Valentine.
Your Valentine. How sweet. Aww.
So this is where apparently this tradition comes from.
Okay, so folklore had, this is what folklore tells us, so isn't that wild?
Yeah, a little bit of Christian tradition, a little bit of folklore, and all mixed together, here we have
Valentine's Day today where we send hearts to everybody. Cool. So, wow.
Yeah.
So now we are going to end the show today with a song. Oh, wait, I want to mention, listen, we've been raising money for this project.
Yeah.
So
this project is a CD. We're making a new album, which is pretty much recorded.
Yeah, with 5 songs, we're going to make a music video, and we have to do a cover. We still have to do that. We've done the recording part of it.
Basically.
And now their guys are working on it in the studio. And then we are going to be filming a music video in the next little while, and also a cover shoot and stuff. So that's what we're into. We needed 50,000 crowns or 10,000 Canadian dollars is what we've been, you know, so and anyone who's been giving to us, that's where the money goes.
Just and we write down all the names.
Yeah.
So far, around 40 something people have given us money.
Yeah. And everybody's going to get a CD when this is done and printed. You will each get a CD sent out to you, all of you who have supported us. So
no matter how much you give.
Yeah, that doesn't matter. So anything you give toward us is going to be going to this project. Until it's paid off and everything.
Yeah,
so.
And we can tell you all that we are halfway there.
Yeah, we are.
So we still need a little bit.
Yep.
We're
halfway.
If you can help us, great. If not, then money will come from somewhere
else. That's right.
So
appreciate it. We just want you along. We're so happy. I'm so glad today. I feel so excited that we're here. And I'm sorry we were late, but you know, that's how it goes. So where you know, at least you hung in there. You didn't just leave.
No.
I mean, I'm so glad to hear there's still people watching. So.
Yeah.
But we're going to sing a Danish song. It's kind of, is it an old, what is it? Explain the song.
Oh, no, don't ask me to do that because then I have to look it up right now. You can just talk and I'll find
out. Well, the song is a Danish song that I didn't understand. I had to sing it. See, what happened is I had to sing with a symphony orchestra, now about 5 years ago. I was asked if I could sing with a symphony orchestra. And so they wanted me to sing this song. So it was like whatever. It's sometimes if something is poetic. For me, poetic stuff is hard enough in English. But trying poetic stuff in Danish is my second language. But Andreas explained to me what all the lyrics meant, like all the prose in it meant. It was so beautiful. And I think it was the first time I really realized how deep things could mean in the Danish language too. I mean, I know it sounds silly, but when you come from only having one language, I grew up with one, I barely French, you know. So, and English is such a large vocabulary and things, so there's all this, but I caught the poetry and the art form and of the Danish language, and I was really touched.
And as we have, as Reg has been speaking, I have been looking it up. It is written by a Danish poet. What do you call him?
A poet
called B.S. Ingemann, and he is famous for a lot of hymns also. But this is actually from a fairy tale, so this is a poem from a fairy tale that has later they have made some music for it.
Okay.
And the song is just painting a picture of winter, where you have everything is covered in snow, and everything is cold, and it seems everything is dark and dead. But there is a little bird singing. And this little bird singing outside is like a prophet that prophesies that things will get better. Because in it tells us, give time. Wait. Give it time.
Be
give
patient.
Some time.
Be patient.
And it's happy, and it's, it shakes its wings, And it says, just be patient because the flowers will bloom again. And then it says, give time because also the tree of life will be green again.
Mm.
Even when the frost is pressing it down. And everything that you dreamt about, at some point you're going to see it with your own eyes. And the last verse, it speaks about the winter of the spirit. That the winter of the spirit will disappear, or the spirit of the winter, or something like that. The sleeping spirit in the winter will disappear, and then the Lord's timing will be there, and His kingdom will overrule everything.
Wow! So it's so deep and it's beautiful. So we're gonna sing this called, and it's, how do you say it in Danish?
I sne står urt og busk I skjul.
So now you get a Danish song.
And this will be our last song for today.
Yeah.
So enjoy.
I sne står urt og busk I skjul. Det så koldt herude. Dog synger der en lille fugl. På kvist ved frosne ruder.
Giv til den nynne glad, og ryste de små vinger. Giv til, og hver en kvist får blad. Giv til, hver blomst du springer. Frosten den kur, bliv til, og vel du drømte skønt, du skal i sandhed skue. Give till
Høstens vind og blond skal flyde for herlig sommer. Giv til og bid på Herrens stånd, hans skønhedsrige kommer.
What year was this written, Andreas?
1831.
Wow. I think that was even before I was born.
Yes.
I know. That's just the way it is.
That's what the way it is.
Time goes marching by.
Yep.
Yes. Listen, I am so happy we got to hang out with you guys today. And I can't wait to go in and read in the comments and see what you've written and see what you've said. And
we hope you have enjoyed it today.
Yeah, we really hope it's been fun. But we'll see you in 2 weeks, okay?
Yeah.
So don't get into any trouble. As I say, don't do anything I wouldn't do, which of course it could give you enough rope to hang yourself. But okay, that wasn't good. But anyway, I do get into trouble sometimes.
Sometimes.
But
you're okay,
Rich.
I'm okay.
Am I
yes,
okay?
You're okay.
All right. He says I'm okay, so I guess I'm okay.
Yeah.
I'm so relieved that he says I'm okay.
He is okay.
Yeah.
So you be okay, and we look forward to seeing you again, and we can't wait 2 weeks from now.
All right, we'll see you in 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Be good. I'll at least do something. Bye.
Bye.